Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome to all Hadith disciples and YouTubers upon the Sunnah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from those who clean ourselves and purify ourselves inwardly and outwardly. Ameen. Today we're here with our brother Muhammad ibn Munir, and we would like to ask him to speak about wudu and its importance in Islam. So first question we want to ask you, Brother Muhammad, is what does wudu mean?
The word wudu linguistically means, or is derived from the word in Arabic al-wada'a. And al-wada'a means beauty. It's husn. Okay? They say a woman is wudu'a. She's a beautiful woman. She's gorgeous. So the word wudu linguistically means not only Islam, but it means to make something sweet and beautiful, to make it look lovely. That's what it means, like, linguistically. As for that slavery, then it is the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the act of obeying Allah by washing specific parts of the body in a specific manner with the intention of making prayer and anything else that wudu is needed for with the proper intention.
Okay, the next question we want to ask you is, what are some of the benefits of wudu from the authentic sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ? And also, what is the proof for wudu? Why do we have to make wudu?
As for virtues, the Prophet ﷺ has explained to us in the authentic hadith that whenever the believer offers the wudu, washes his face, washes his hands, washes his feet, every sin that he looked at, every sin that he walked towards, every sin that he touched or grabbed, whatever he used his hands for in disobedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, will fall. The hadith says the last drop of water that falls off his bones, his arms, his face, that's the last sin that we can move from.
So you're saying that wudu is a means of him attaining forgiveness?
Yes, being forgiven of your sins, being purified of your sins, and being, as Ibn Qayyim explained, beautiful inwardly and outwardly.
Allahu Akbar.
And people who make wudu and pray, there's no doubt there's a light in their faces. There's a light in their hearts also. May Allah give us that.
Ameen.
As for the obligation of making wudu, then we have the Quran of Kareem Surah Ma'idah. Allah's Wazir has clearly instructed us, Ya Ayyuhal Ladina Amanu Idha Qumtum Ila Salati Fasilu Wujuhakum Alayha. Allah says, oh, you believe, إِذَا قُمْتُمْ إِلَى الصَّلَاةِ. Allah says, when you stand up for the prayer, do what?
Wash your
فَغْسِلُوا
وَجُوهَكُمْ. Wash
your faces. To the end of the
ayah.
Allah tells us to wash our faces, wash our arms, wipe our heads, and wash our feet to the ankles. Okay? The sunnah of the Messenger of Allah, صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said to أَبْوْسِمْ صَلَاتَهُ, the one who prayed badly, said, إِذَا قُمْتُمْ إِلَى الصَّلَاةَ فَأَسْبِغِ الْوُضُوءُ. He says, when you stand in the prayer, then perfect your wudu. So if we command him to perfect his wudu, then of course he's going to command him to do the basic necessities of wudu.
So are there different kinds of wudu? Like different ways to make it?
Right. The people of knowledge explain there are two main ways of making it. Two. One is the obligatory way, or the bare necessities of wudu. And the second type of wudu is something that is voluntary. Something that's virtuous, derogatory, it's extra. Certain things to do that you don't have to do, but they're good and preferable to do.
Okay. Can you give us an example?
Right. As for the first way of making wudu, then it's very simple and it's very easy. Now pay attention, what I don't do intentionally is intentional. Okay? You notice I'm not going to say bismillah, I'm not going to wash my hands first. I'm going to do the bare necessities of wudu.
Okay?
I just wash my arms once, not two times. And that's not even obligatory. Wipe from front to back of the head. Wash the foot, the toes, to the ankle, once. Not to my shin, just above my ankle, that's it. Just once. Just above the ankle, that's it. One time. So, when we pay attention here, we see that some of the things that I didn't do, I didn't say bismillah, I didn't use miswak, I didn't say dua afterwards, I didn't wash my hands two times before the wudu, I didn't wash my parts three times, I didn't wash to my muscle, my bicep, nor my calf. I did none of that. I did a basic, simple wudu. And according to many scholars, putting water in the nose and the mouth is not even obligatory. Just washing the face. And there's some of them now who say, you don't get too technical, that you must put water in the mouth and the nose. That is the bare, basic, necessity of water. Going to the back, going up to the front is not obligatory, just once. And some of them now say, even wiping some of the head as the bare necessity of water. As for the recommended wudu, then first and foremost is to use the miswak. You might want to wash it, make sure it's clean and fresh, prior to cleaning your teeth. Inside, out high, you're ready to part of the wudu. Okay, then you will say bismillah. You say bismillah. And you will start off by washing your hands, not your arms, thrice. Once, twice, thrice. Once, twice, thrice. Take a full cup of water into your mouth. Once, half your mouth and half your nose, three times. Inhale it thoroughly and push it out strongly. Wash the face three times with three double handful or handfuls or scoops of water. Thoroughly. Once. Twice. Three times. For brothers that have beards, mashallah, it's recommended to make tahleel al-lihya, to wipe the beard, to put your fingers to it. I don't have a beard, so it's not too much you have to do. Next is from the fingertips to the elbows, three times, all the way to my bicep. Thoroughly wash me, leaving no dry spots. Thoroughly.
Now, why is it that you have to go all the way to the bicep?
Now, if that's recommended act, as I was going to go along narrating this on Muslim, that from the benefits on Yom Kippur, the signs of wudu. The head should not be wiped three times, only once. Nope, wash your head, just wipe it. From your hairline in the front, to the nape of your neck, back to the hairline and your ears. And many scholars say that the ears are not obligatory to be wiped. And a few small number of scholars say that you do have to wipe your ears. Then your feet, from your toes to your calf muscle, as the sunnah explained. Three times, thoroughly. Digging between your toes, thoroughly. Some scholars say you might have to dig between your toes. Recommended. Three times. And then after that, you say, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, wahdahu la sharika lah, wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluhu. Allahumma ja'alni min at-tawwabin, wa ja'alni min al-mutatahhirin.
Amen.
I want you to bear witness to the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, along with any partner, that Muhammad is his slave and messenger. Oh Allah, make it for those who purify themselves and those who make repentance. Now, some basic mistakes that we'll do, we're going to go over in brief for the little time that we have. From the common mistakes that we have in wudu is to think that you have to wash your hands three times in the beginning. That's not obligatory. And that misunderstanding leads to another misunderstanding, which is when people wash their hands in the beginning of wudu, and they come to their arms, they only wash their wrists to their elbows. Because they did what? They washed it in the beginning.
Mm.
So they leave off that which is obligatory for that which is?
Recommended.
And that's the sour fruit of ignorance. The sour fruit of not knowing, not studying.
Seek refuge in Allah from ignorance.
I mean, another common mistake is for people to have the belief that you can't wipe off the braids. Or if a woman has long hair, or if a man has long hair, then he has to scrub his scalp. No, it's simple. Take the water, if you have long hair, from the front, and that's it. Not back to the front again. If you can't pray with cornrows, why not? Because the wudu has to reach your scalp. Who said that? A woman can pray and make ghusl when she has braids, let alone salat. Okay? That's another common mistake in the wudu. Another common mistake in the wudu is wasting water. Even if the water is recycled, you don't want to get too technical, water, you know, is brought back, isn't such thing, but they just use too much water. Or some people, they have dry spots. They don't wash their parts thoroughly, okay? Another common mistake in wudu is for a person to ignore the sunnah and always make the bare necessity. If you have time, it's not cold, you're not in a rush, you have enough water, you should make a thorough wudu because it's a means of purification of sin, protection of fire, brightness, and blaze on the day of judgment, the blaze of the horse, the whiteness of the horse's forehead. Limbs, and that's a sign of beauty in the horse. Okay, another common mistake in wudu is for a person to say, you can't say bismillah when you're making wudu. because you have what? You're in hamam. First of all, this is not the hamam. This is not when no one is using the bathroom. This is a wudu area. The name is different, the place is different. Okay? So some scholars say the same bismillah is obligatory and others, the majority saying that it isn't. There are many other mistakes that people make in the wudu. This is all the time we have in this video. Hopefully it was beneficial.
JazakAllah khair.
Alhamdulillah, maybe we have some hadith disciples when they get into the video. Wallahu a'lam, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, mubarak ala abihi wa sallam.
JazakAllah khair.
Thank you very much.
Until the next time, we'll see you later. Assalamu alaikum.